And this one. You want to eat that one?
Si kana peleka angwa tu.
The male must be there, and that's the small one.
To lay an egg there, guys. You see, and right now.
And we have the big ones.
I want to start my video with a question. Maybe in your country, when it rains, does electricity get lost? Because here, like the company that gives us electricity, it's called KPLC. I think when it rains, they just... You see the way you'd unhang, you'd collect clothes from the hanging light. That's what they do to the electricity. What do you think?
I think that's so, because it usually happens like even when it rains and it goes, that's just like it's a normal thing.
Yes.
In Kenya.
Guys, let me know in the comment section, in your country when it rains, does electricity disappear? Okay, guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Chalukush is my name. And thank you so much for all the returning subscribers. God bless you so much.
Yeah, my name is Linet_KE. And welcome, guys, to Chalukush channel. Kindly subscribe to mine as well.
And Linet_KE.
Yes.
Guys, today is a bright morning. And you remember yesterday. So today, I actually want to see the results of how we worked yesterday. Because yesterday, it rained heavily. Heavily. You heard that, the amount of rain.
Yeah, it rained heavily.
It was heavy. Mm-hmm. And one thing, we forgot to return the wheelbarrows. You see what's happening.
They are full.
Yes, guys. We forgot to... And today, there's a lot of echo. What's happening?
I don't know.
There's a lot of echo today, guys. I don't know if you can feel it. You see, we forgot the hammer here. It's not me. I know it's Kina Collins and no.
No, but you're supposed to be me returning everything.
And this is my neighbor's wheelbarrow, guys. But you're going to return them.
You will wash it.
Yeah, we will wash it and then we dry it. And it's okay. Everything is okay. And did you realize what the chicken did to our rice husks here? The chicken, they are so not... They thought this is rice.
Mm.
So they came in here and they started chakura.
They were trying to find food.
Just close it and I think they are coming to confirm if the stock is there.
They will even tear this.
You know, I feel like telling these people, you know, guys, we have a chicken here that doesn't belong to us. It just came and it's like the fourth day today. And we still haven't found the owners.
Very comfortable.
Very comfortable. They even sleep together. So we'll just have to keep it. And they, you know, when you lose something in the village, you have to walk to your adjacent neighbors and ask.
Yeah, so, or you just keep it, wait for somebody to come and ask.
Yeah.
And then they come for, you just give it to them.
Yeah.
But I think that's a norm because even in my home, we used to lost our chicken. Like you see, ours are just roaming around.
Yes.
So when they find their friends outside there, they just go with them. And then you just go and find it in your jirani.
Your neighbor.
If your neighbor is a good neighbor.
Yeah, they can keep it.
But some neighbors used to eat.
To eat them.
Yes.
So guys, this this is my faro. But you know, my contractor, this one should not be here.
Yeah.
Because it will weaken the sides of the sewer tank. And now, this is where they added the stones and... Collins and Dennis, thank you so much for the good work. I really appreciate this. Eh? Yeah, so this is how they, I told you this is how they poured the stones. And from the way the water was flowing today, I don't think like there's any damage.
But it didn't rain that heavy compared to
the... Yeah, but it's good. Yes. They did a very good job. And I love how these chicken are just eating the grass here. Yeah, they are feeding. Is this what you call the grass-fed chicken, pasteurized, organic chicken? Yeah, they just try to find food for themselves. Okay, good morning. Okay, so guys, we want to go to the other side of the gate and see, because actually I took some clips when it was raining, so we want to go and confirm if everything worked well. Yeah, some water went through. Are you the one who poured some ash here?
Yeah, the other day, but not today.
Okay. So guys, yesterday the water, I think the water is flowing nicely. You see this pot here, it's flowing and there is no effect on the fence. I think it's flowing nicely.
I'm just passing there because that's the way.
Yes. I've actually called someone to come and remove the anthill. Yeah, there's someone who commented in the comment section, there's no way we're going to deal with termites when you don't remove the queen.
The lights are
still on. Oh, okay, electricity has come.
Has just come.
Guys, you know, I told you here, electricity, when it rains, electricity usually goes. What have you seen there? Why is this one not covered? You know, during the rainy season, things can enter through here.
It was covered. I think the kids has removed
it. Yeah, we are going to cover it. Maybe, where do you think we can go? Maybe we can try to go and check. Yeah, guys, you see? The water was flowing, but I think we'll still need to do a very good gabion. Is it called a gabion or a very good furrow? Because I think in Kenya, guys, there's a very big problem with the, let me say, drainage system. Because most of the roads sometimes they have they are in a very big mess.
Not Kenya only. When it rains heavily, it rains. Like you see currently in other places, other countries. Hmm. Like the other day I was looking at Russia. Hmm. It carried away the houses.
In Russia, so, and I also saw like in Dubai, the airplanes were carried
away
by the floods.
The roads were flooding.
Here comes the time for the dogs now.
Why is my chamber?
Why are the dogs so notorious?
They think that we have a lot of food.
This is very, let me say, notorious of the dogs.
I've seen a lizard.
You've seen a lizard? Hey, it's running. Mm-hmm. Okay, it's gone. I don't know. Imagine the dogs, usually we put the stones and then they come and remove them. I'm going to put a very huge stone there and then we'll see where they are going to pass. And I think I can do it right now.
See
you. It's here?
Yeah.
Is it okay now?
Yeah, I think it's okay.
Now let's see where they're going to pass. They are very notorious because in most cases when you place a stone here, they are going to find another spot here in between. Can I bring another stone for another spot or everything is okay there?
I think it's okay.
Okay.
Let me add this one here so that.
Hey, and our cock today is very, it's just cuckooing.
Marking territory. To be a man of the house.
That's how they mark territories. Mm. Okay. Wow. Let's go on the other side and confirm. So you see how this, how the water was flowing. You see from here?
Hey.
Where?
Stop.
You see how it's...
wrong? Please, me mean a dog's
no, I know you. Okay, go. Let them go. So at least I think we solved the problem somehow, Lynette. Mm. But not the problem. Mm. I think also our adjacent neighbor needs to work on this nini place.
Mm. The water needs to follow the road.
Yeah. And some people have been telling me, oh, Chalo, can we be your neighbor?
Yeah, you can.
Can be, guys.
Actually, this land here.
This land is on sale. I think he sold a small part. And we also have some other parts there that are available, guys.
Yeah.
And in case you need the land here, I always give the phone number.
Contact.
Yeah, the contact.
Mm.
Yeah. And he's selling an eighth of land at 1.1 million Kenya shillings. So in case you need the land, an eighth of land is 50 by 100, guys. So that's the rate here. Sounds expensive, maybe. I know some people.
Yeah, for me, to be honest,
it's
expensive. Yeah. Because when you compare it to Nairobi, some other places of Nairobi, and given that this is a Apani village, this is, okay, it's not that village, but it's village.
Yes.
We are not in the city.
Yes.
Yeah, it sounds expensive. But if you can afford, guys, just...
But you know, sometimes you might say it's expensive, but you see to someone, guys, finally our plan worked. You see, you can see like the water was flowing, like flowing freely up to the far end of that place. Yeah, so there is no significant amount of water that went to our land. There is no amount went to our place, guys.
Yeah. We will come and see it from the inside.
Lynette, okay? Water still passed.
Water still passed?
Yes, you see when you try to look down here, you see there is some flow of water. You can, yeah. It even removed the bin from...
Let's go and inspect and see where.
Guys, you see like our dustbin, like the overflow there, like we have the plastic. Okay, we're going to see from the inside. Maybe we can go on the other side and inspect. Let's see where the water was seeping in. Or maybe there's another spot from our other neighbor.
The rain which comes from this side, yeah. It passes through these furrows.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's where it passed.
So we dug that furrow yesterday.
But here back up, it was just okay, you see?
Yeah, it worked. Mm-hmm. Up to this spot, it worked, guys, and then... guys, okay, let's go on the other side. Maybe there's somewhere. Maybe it's passing to our... Oh, okay, there's a nini here.
It's here.
This is a broken... this is the path now, you see? This is why it's seeping through. You see, you can see how this... Yeah, this is where the water is passing. Now what will we do to solve this? Because I think if we just say like we'll be following each and every day, maybe in the long run, we'll meet ourselves on the other side of the road. Maybe we'll try to create a drainage up to the other side.
What we will do is, you see that part of the dustbin? We need to cover the dustbin and do it in another place so that when water comes, the same way it's passing through this land, passing through our neighbor's land, let it pass through ours, let it pass through hers.
Or maybe we can just say, we can be sorting our dustbin. We just cover that and then we sort our dustbin. We'll be burning the papers and the other waste, we'll be taking them to the garbage site on the marketplace.
No, we can just have
a small one. Mm-hmm. Guys, what do you think?
That's the best way. Just do it in another place so that when water comes, because instead of having that as a barrier, the pit as a barrier, let it pass through. Because
or maybe, yes.
It comes from here, it passes through our neighbors, and it gets to this neighbor, our cross neighbor, and then it gets to our land.
Yes.
So when it gets to our land, let it pass.
Let it pass.
Because it's from up there.
Yeah, but I've also been seeing people have been constructing a concrete dustbin somehow. Yeah.
The one that you can burn.
Yeah, the one that you can burn things from the inside. Looks like an incinerator or something.
Like this one, it's just coming.
Yeah, here. I've ever seen an incinerator. Do you know an incinerator? It burns everything. You see even how this place here, this is how water is flowing, guys. So when you talk about the effects... Do you know the guy was constructing the furrows yesterday here? You remember when we were passing here?
So I was telling you...
Yes.
You see the same way water came from that, from top?
Yes.
It came all the way up to his land.
Yes.
Others were coming here, others are moving to this land.
Yes.
So let it go the way it goes.
Yeah, let it go, guys. You see how these furrows were really working well for him. Like the sweet potatoes haven't been affected, not even a single way. And you see like there's a flow of water all the entire place. Yeah. Wow. Guys, I think we need to work on this so we don't have to drain each and every day. And also in our garden, we really have to work on removing the anthills because they destroyed our passion fruit, and I really can't imagine the struggle we have passed through to just raise the fruit. It hasn't been easy, yeah, but we're still trying to work on it. Let's go on the inside, maybe wait for the person who's going to come and fix to remove the anthills.
It passes there, the water passes there.
Here.
This is where it gets the barrier. Now when it overflows, the other day when it rained heavily, it overflowed. So haikupata place ya kuteremka hivi. It didn't get place to go. That's why it went to our, you know, instead of going this way, it went to our
True. Now I see
very
the problem.
Bad, and it's not supposed to be like that. So when it comes, let it go.
Yeah, we'll have to let it flow.
Because it has passed on our neighbors. The next neighbor, our land, let it pass on our neighbor to go
to the other place. Because also, it's also flowing to... You see, our neighbor's place, though it has just created only one furrow. Yeah, the big furrow. So we also have to let it find its own path and go.
Yes. Instead of passing through our home, you know, now it's going the opposite way.
Yeah,
instead of going this way.
The solution right now will be to just... Yeah, you see, okay, we are talking about this, guys. You see how our neighbor is letting the flow to just go. Like, he is not even concerned, you see?
If you try to cover it,
yes,
it will come and destroy it.
That's where the problem comes in.
Because you see, the other part of this land is up.
Yeah, it's not affected, by the way. So, I think we'll have to maybe cover our dustbin so the water won't be retained there. Yeah, because you see, this furrow is really working well for him, and he doesn't have to strain to. He just let the water create its own path to flow, to go. Yeah, that's nice. And I love the look of our homes, our home here and our neighbor's place. I really love the roofing. It looks quite impressive. Yeah, looks good. Wow. And sometimes you just try to look on this house, sometimes you think it's so big, but on the other side, we didn't want to construct a small house. For me, I always don't want to go, like I always say, I don't want to go back to the market. When I buy something, I just want to buy something that I'll not be going back tomorrow to buy once again. So let's wait and see how the day. Oh, the chicken. You know, guys, you have to always close our gate so like the chicken won't go on the outside, and they're really feasting on the grass. Guys, welcome to our home. Yeah, that's where we're constructing the chicken house. We are thinking of adding some more chicken. Yeah, we really love how they give a good look on our home. Yeah, and the pigeons will just give birth and replicate, but we are more concerned with the chicken right now. Yeah. What happened to your lemongrass?
The other one yesterday when people were walking there, you stepped on it.
No?
Yeah.
We were passing there and we just got it when it's already stepped on.
Oh, see, it's the only all the people that, you know, you maybe you couldn't have stepped on it, but somebody else might have stepped on it.
Maybe.
Yes.
And the lemongrass, Lynette, tell us, you're the one that brought all this.
So the lemongrass, actually, guys, you know, it has a citrus feeling, not smell.
Yes.
Yeah. Now the citrus smells chase away the snakes. So the reason as to why I planted them all around is to chase the snakes away. I'm one person who is very afraid of snakes. So because it was raining, and you know, our house is not covered that well, especially on the door. Doorpost. Are they
yes.
called doorpost?
It's because we don't have the tiles. Like the door places, they are called the
doorpost. Okay,
door frames down there.
Yeah. So I was like, maybe a snake might come because it's been raining a lot.
I remember. Lynette made us spend the whole day trying to cover every spot in the house where rodents, what,
yeah, even
chameleons.
You know, since we covered, I don't know, since that day, frogs doesn't make noise nowadays.
The frogs don't make noise. Mm. We've never seen chameleons. Lizards aren't quite as much, but you just saw one there.
Yeah.
But not be much of a problem.
Yeah. But lizards are just okay.
Yeah, they're quite okay.
Compared to snakes.
Nothing
and
okay.
Crickets.
They're called, reptiles.
Here.
Crickets.
Hey, they were here.
Yes.
I forgot all.
Maybe let's go and see how our garden is faring. Because, guys, we were here yesterday, but I just showed you how the water has affected. But today, I think the flow was very minimal. Yes. Okay, not much of a difference from what we saw yesterday. But at the same, Lynette, we need to harvest this black nightshade or else we'll not be eating them. Guys, you see this black nightshade here?
I can harvest them right now.
Yeah, Yeah, maybe we can
have a lot of food. Yeah. You know, guys, because it's raining and it's in the village, the other time I was the only one who was having food around. So people used to come and sell for them. So right now, because the michicha is growing, I know Kenyans know this.
Michicha.
Michicha is terere. Amaranth. They are growing in their land. You know, amaranth. Like this one, we didn't plant it. It just grew
by itself.
Yes. So they have somewhere to pluck and eat, so they don't come to buy. So that's why we have a lot.
a lot. Yeah. You see,
but
even...
It's okay.
Hey, but the nightshade, I think they are the, let me say, most dominant. They
right
really...
Now. They're
the most shyness. Most shyness. You see, guys, even just imagine such kind of a live on one of it. Like
things that are dominating right now is the chaos.
Black
followed
night.
By the pumpkins.
Pumpkins also, and also the this is the amaranth, guys. You see how good they are doing? Like they are really they're really dominating as well. They are doing well.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I love them, by the way.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
One thing I love about this garden is when we started, it wasn't that productive as per se, but we really pushed on until we get the well.
Yes.
And by the time we were getting the well, the rain came.
Yes.
So we've never watered. Yes. We tried just once to test our sprinkler and we found out that it's just nini.
What
the rain started raining.
Yes.
So you see, Charlo now, here. Here that we were coming.
Yeah.
So you see when the water comes,
this is how it's flowing.
You see its direction is to go this way.
Yes.
Chin. This way.
Yeah, because the water should be flowing downwards. Just watch out so you don't.
Yeah, so it's supposed to be going this way.
Yes.
So when it comes here
and meets
it finds a barrier.
Yes. You see
and
how
this is the barrier.
Yeah, you see guys, this is the look of our dustbin from here. And you see this how the water is flowing on the inside. So if there's no hole here, it would just be going. And you see like it's almost plunging in. Like you see how the soil is just from the side is just falling in.
And you see,
yeah, so imagine this one. So each and every day we'll just be repeating the same thing.
But another thing, Chalo, we need to sort out our dustbin.
Yes.
Plastics to be different and also they need to be different.
Yeah. Because I've seen like for the food remains, we can just make them as compost.
Compost.
Yeah, just we be just throwing them on the garden.
Yeah, on a separate place, right?
Yeah.
Now the water is supposed to be going this way. So, Nona, because here, you see, because you made this here, now the water came to our neighbor.
Okay, I can
but
see
it's
there.
Supposed to be passing this
it
way,
should pass
be honest. You see even the land is slanted this way.
Yes,
so it's supposed to be going this way.
Yeah, I can see steps for the dogs here. I think they came here for the spot where they usually pass and they met a closed gate. Yes, I think we'll just let's go bring this here and then we fork jembe and then we return everything back. We forgot to close the gate and our chicken just followed. Hey, we have to chase them away. They have really been eating the, how they are they called? The cabbage. They are really eating them. Skuma zisha ashika, sindio? Like we planted kales like 2 days ago and they are already well established on the ground. Guys, you know we planted some new kales and I think, Lynette, we need to work out on our kales. Because we'll have plenty of kales that... You see these ones, these are the ones that you planted. They are doing, imagine this one is the youngest. We need to be harvesting them.
Oh, we need to be harvesting them.
Yes, and you need to work on this one. Let me work on it right now.
Okay.
So after I showed you guys our apple was destroyed, was broken. So for Sky and Bloodly suggested to me, like I take this apple plant and dip it in water and let's wait and see if it's going to develop some roots.
Yeah, it can.
It can.
Yeah. But
so
it
still
remained with a branch.
But you know that's not an apple.
Oh.
That's a loquat. It's called a loquat.
Loquat? What does that mean?
The yellow fruit. Do you know the yellow fruit that has a seed on the inside? The small one. There's a... Okay, maybe very soon I'm going to show it. I'll show you on the internet. No, it was grafted on apple.
Oh.
Like an apple is usually grafted on a loquat.
Okay.
All the apples. Yeah. So... This one, I think, let me just go and dip it in water and let's wait and see the results.
Let's do.
Yes. And guys, I remember on yesterday's video, I was asking the name of that big tree there. You see that tree, Lynette? That's there. Unaona ile yenye iko na inakaa matunda mavitu marefu marefu.
Yeah, I know it in
What's
our
the
language.
Name?
In our language.
Okay.
You know, it's believed that when you have small boobs,
yes,
breasts,
eh?
You take that thing,
eh?
You just okay, you pluck two, you
eh?
Put them here,
eh?
And you start singing a certain song, so
and
that
then,
put them here,
eh?
And you start singing a certain song, so
and
that
then?
You have big breasts.
Okay.
Anyway,
I was told it's called sausage tree.
Sausage tree.
Yeah.
I sausage don't know, but walai, that's how they call it in our nani. Muriba.
Muriba?
Eh.
Okay.
When you go around singing, then you'll have big, you know, most of the women love having big breasts.
Yes.
So,
okay. Now, Lynette, why have we forgotten our cucumber?
You know, they were washed away by the
I think we need to plant new.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it's
we need
only this
only one. I showed them yesterday.
You can plant them right now. It's because we just throw the seed.
And I think we need to work. We either have to remove the pumpkin,
mm-hmm,
because even the person who is working on the fence won't have a good time.
And let me ask you, what are
these? These are watermelons, or maybe we uprooted some.
Mm-mm. I think. Those cucumbers, are they cucumbers?
Yes.
The seeds fallen here, like this one.
That's not a cucumber.
Mm.
That's a watermelon.
Oh.
Yeah, but you're going to control this watermelon so they don't overgrow here. Yeah, so let's go on the other side. So let me go dip this one in water right away. So I was told to dip it in water. So let me dip it in this one here. Like that. But I think I should cut these ones. Yes, I should cut the tops.
Don't cut them.
They should be cut.
Hmm.
Yes.
Okay,
like anytime you're trying to, is it propagation or something,
hmm,
you should cut so it can have some new shoots on
okay
the sides. Because this one, there's no it's going to grow. Or maybe you can just throw it in like that. And then wait and see the results after a few days.
We are hopeful.
Yeah.
There's
no difference because the same way it would have rained.
Hey, that one is clean.
It looks clean.
Mm. That's the beauty of the rain. Comes with very clean water.
The water is very clean.
Ikarisha hivyo I drip.
Let me just. There it's okay.
Mm.
I hope it doesn't, but no one is going to go there.
Among the Zeka side.
So it will dry faster. See that?
Mm. It's not going to rust.
Yes. Stay there. Maybe let's just put these ones here to dry.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, kuradhi atia. Ne oka eh.
Yeah.
Hey, andu makore ne.
Musiki kone ne.
Ah. Yeah, he's called Stano.
Yeah.
He was also part of the people who are handmen in our constructions, isn't he?
Yeah.
Yes. Welcome. He's the one who is going to fix our anthills. I'm asking him, is it not so slippery? Yeah, and it has a carriage space here. Yeah, some water. Yeah. Oh, we make sure we add in the tools.
Mm.
Okay.
Mm.
Okay, guys, let's go and see if we are going to see the anthills. Is it called the anthills or the queen?
Okay.
They are called the queens.
Queen, yeah.
Yes. So we have to go and look around. Kitugwa?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guys, so let's go and see. Because I haven't seen where the termites have drawn, like the way they draw soil on top, maybe like a heap, the way they would pile some soil. I haven't seen that, but Let's see if he'll know. Unaona kama hapa ilikausha hii mtunda yote hii. Mm-hmm. Alafu kuna hii yenye imekauka hivi. Mm-hmm. Alafu pia kulikuwa si unaona hata hii. Si unaona? Yeah. See guys, this is also another dried passion fruit. Mm-hmm. Alafu ikakuja pia ikakata hapa. Mhm. Unaona hapa? Hapa. Imekata hapo. Mhm. Ehe. Sasa sijui kuna hapo pale na hapo.
Sasa inaendanga 1 km.
1 km? Kilometer ama 100 meters?
Oh, 100 meter.
100 meters. Yeah. So it has to be around here.
Kutoka mahali queen yako,
sinaendaga
100 meter, 100 meter.
Uh-huh.
Sasa inaweza toka mpaka kwa mwenyewe.
Kwa neighbor.
Kwa neighbor inakuja.
Sasa tuangalie.
Na kuna tatu, sijui karaoke alikuwa ananiambia moja iko.
Other, even my neighbor said he wants you to go and check today. So after this, we are going to my neighbor's place.
Yeah.
Okay. The only cucumber that has survived is this one that our daughter planted. And there's no way I thought we have an existing cucumber. You see, this is the cucumber plant here. And oh, I think it's almost cut down. I don't know if it's the rain or the mites. Hey, I don't even know, guys. We have a very big problem and we really need to work on this. So let him walk around, look, and then we are going to my neighbor's place and remove the queens as well. Oh, hapa kunaweza kuwa na moja? So here there's a probability of having. So it's just like this is our neighbor's land. You see the bananas. We are still doing the hunt, guys, for the hunt hills here. So we have a probability for one there because you say it goes 100 meters and it's around 100 meters here. Yeah. And this banana is already ripening from the top. And I know all this will be eaten by birds. If we don't harvest them, they'll be eaten by birds. Hey, this one. Okay. Let me peel. It really tastes good. I'm going to remove some more. I'm only cutting the right ones.
Make sure you cut well.
Yes.
Here's the plakika.
Like that.
Guys, we have a ripe one here.
I'd imagine it's just 2 days old since the last time we cut.
2 days.
Yes. Another one. Cut this one. This one, I'm the one that just ate. I heard you say it's a bird. I think they are enough now.
The other one, you?
This one?
But that one is still okay. Haijapasuka chalo, just leave it alone.
Situenda tuweka kwa zile zenye zinaiva?
No, just leave it, haijapasuka.
Okay.
Hey.
And then the good thing, guys, is we bought this banana. So don't say like you're eating from our neighbor's place.
Imagine one hand of that banana gives us...
Yeah.
How fast?
Okay.
He's an expert.
Let's go and see. Now you've even abandoned the bananas. Ay, how fast was that? Hey, Stano, 2 minutes. This is the queen.
Na male yake.
That's the male.
Yeah, this is usually the male.
How do you know that's the male?
Guy.
Oh, can I touch it?
Yes, you can touch. And I've seen some people eat them.
Yun chakura.
This is food.
Yeah.
And these ones here are called feeders. You see these ones down there, guys. The problem is solved.
Nivo. Hii huwa kutoka. Nivo. Hawa ata hii wataenda kisha waishe.
They will die.
Oh. Wana survive juu wanaongeshwa na huyo.
Oh, this one is the multiplier.
Mayai yake ni
kutoka. Yeah, because I see, guys.
Sino inakaa sukari.
Looks like the eggs look like sugar.
Have you ever seen a queen bee machine?
Queen bee. Okay, guys, this
queen
is the.
Is it queen bee?
Queen. Have you ever seen this one, Haley?
Mom, touch it.
Do you want to touch?
do like this and feel how.
Guys, and you see they are mating. You see, like the queen. Let me show you from the shed. You see there?
Really?
Yeah.
So I at us now.
Yes, there's a chicken.
Kwako.
Eh.
Asiunipe but kitu ni wake. Hichi akura cha kuku ba.
That's okay. Go and bring somewhere we put it for the chicken.
Karai ndo. Amangunia.
They will.
Ai, cha akura cha kuku.
Let me bring. Mom.
I've seen people eat this one. You want to see? This is how it looks, Hailey. So guys, this is a closer look for the mess that you have been dealing with. So Sano has told us this is the queen. The queen is always fed by the feeders. The feeders are these small ones. Yeah. And then this is the
male.
The male. And you can imagine the male is so small. I can't even imagine.
Where is the head of the queen?
The head is this one here. This is the head and this is the tail. So when you remove this one, you have solved the problem of termites on your home, because like this is the one that produces the small termites that ate our grafted passion. So that's where the problem is solved. And let's wait if Sano is going to get some more, and we're also going to check on our neighbor's place, because our neighbor just called me and told me he has a big problem as well. So that's a closer look. Yeah, like that, guys. Yes.
So you say that is food for chicken?
This is nini azitakula tumbo ya nini ya kuku? Hapana.
Stano mejua aje kwa hapa?
Nini? How did you know it's here? Ulijua aje kwa?
Experience mara.
Experience. Hey, and he has dug it in like less than 5 minutes, and
less
it's out.
Than
3 minutes.
Kwa mni kuangi mbali hivo?
Kuna zenye zinaendanga mbali na kuna zenye zinakuanga, sinakuanga mara tatu.
Kuna zenye ziko?
Different. Kuna zenye zinaendanga chini mpaka na chimba na mimi naisha ulefu wangu.
Aya.
Nikitafuta.
Okay, sometimes he can dig a hole like bigger than his size. As we are asking Stano where he's going to take this. He says like if he don't eat it, he's going to eat.
But we are not going to cook it, he will eat. Hey,
Stano, uko shoe unaweza kula hii?
Si sai sai.
Acha.
You eat this one?
Hizi ndo zinaletanga nini? Vipepeo. Zile zenye zinakuja.
Si lazima upike.
Hizi ndizo zinaendanga sasa zinaweza ingia 100 meter hivo na cookie sababisa tu kiasi ama isikie tu
movement.
Sinarudi biombio.
Oh.
Na sinafanyanga kazi usiku.
They only work at night. So the chicken will eat all this.
Yeah.
The chicken
is chakula cha kuku.
Okay. Wewe sasa hii wewe ndo unajua na.
Nipe Hailey ashikilie mara moja ndo pesa na.
Utanibebea.
Sawa, shika Hailey.
Mom said you going to search.
Ebu tuna kuja anga huko. Basi. Hiyo ika hivyo.
Okay.
Senye zimebaki na hizi ziko huku huku.
The chicken is going to eat. Okay, let's go and show Caleb. Okay. Look at how my daughter is holding it. The excitement. Look, guys. She's even calling her friend. Enough, Hailey.
Kuja uone.
Caleb, utoke uone.
Si ndio, eh?
Nuluona keki?
Ishike.
Nuluona nendo e? Nuko njita?
Ishike.
Okay, Hailey, is enough. They are here, so our chicken, they are going to come and they are going to eat them. So this one, kama hizi zitakaa siku ngapi ndio zikufe kama hazijakulwa?
Hai, ni leo tu hiyo jua.
Oh, so these ones, if the chicken don't eat, they'll just die today and they are not going to reproduce. So I'm really happy, guys. For me, the first time I've seen this thing here and a problem is somehow solved. So hata hii tukiekelea hapa itaenda mahali.
Lambda ikuliwe na kuku.
Wacha ni
weka
let me play. He's saying let me place. He's telling me to place it here. It's his food, so let me do as per his will, because it's not going anywhere. Even me. We also have this hole here, guys, that has been sucking in water. So anytime we've been watering using pipes or maybe when it's raining, so water usually seeps here, through here. So he's already working it on it from the other side. Yeah, and guys, that's how our fence is working in a way like you can't even see him. You see, you can only see the action, but you can't see the actual person. Yeah. Subscriber told me like Forget the perimeter walls for now, but our fence like looks really good. Thank you so much.
Very beautiful. Yeah. Just right now is when I'm just
realizing
the beauty. Yes. The beauty of this live fence compared to the to the perimeter.
Yes.
Like because we are in the village, it looks very good.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah. The village fence, guys, looks awesome. So here we haven't found one, and also on the other side there's none. So okay, and we have some sweet potatoes, like the one that Anita has brought. Anita, say ma hello. Okay, she has got them from our neighbor, the one who has bananas. Yeah. Hey. For free, guys. Guys, this is order to Tamaliza. Wait. Lynette, come and see. Guys, will you be able to finish this one? So we got all this from our neighbor. We have very good neighbors, you know. And our neighbor is there. She's actually... Umemua kutu spoil? Eh, she has chosen spoiling us. Ugo to spoil unangu ase. Nisiyahu?
Si Anita.
Where? Guys, these are a lot of sweet potatoes.
Mechuna wapi? Uko naza?
Wait. Wait. They want to eat our pigeons. I want to kucheza. You know, kids don't take any chances with water, so we just poured water here, and Haley has just, she even removed her shoes. Haley, so you just want to play with mud? Okay. Guys, this is what we really missed to do when we were kids. Playing with mud. What did you love to do when you were, like, what's one of the biggest childhood memories? For us, we used to make a place very slidey, and we could run, and then we slide with two legs. It was really nice. And these dogs, you know, they almost ate our pigeons. They are from our neighbor. Yeah, our neighbor came with them. They are going the other way. I'm telling them I don't want to see them here. Tony. Yeah, has to go away. Yeah, let the dog go home. Because we almost ate our pigeons. We don't want that. Oh, I've seen. Have you seen the chicken is stuck there?
It's not stuck.
It's stuck.
Tries to give back.
Do you know there's a time it was stuck? It entered the pigeon's place to lay eggs. You see, like right now, it's trying to come out. You see? It's stuck. You should close this place with a stone. Guys, don't mind. I'm still.
Anita, meza mayai.
Anita, meza mayai. She's trying to come out. Okay, come out by yourself then. Just pull it slowly. So it doesn't hurt itself. It's very hard. Listen, Kushke. You know, it's quite deep. You see, there's already an egg there, so it went to reproduce to lay an egg there, guys. You see, and right now
it always lay.
We should be closing this spot because this is the second time I've seen it doing that.
It always lay eggs down here.
I don't know where it went to do today.
And this,
where did you go?
The other pigeon is here.
Hey, finally, it managed to come out by itself. Where's the pigeon?
It's here. Oh,
and the pigeon is on the inside. Okay. Just remove the egg. Yeah, you see, guys, the egg. I hope it almost damaged it, but it's okay.
No.
It's okay. Yeah, so let me pour this on. Let's pour.
For them.
Yeah, pour them there.
Come on, eat.
Pour them. Okay, evenly. Yeah. Now they are go. Hey, finally the celebration begins. Yeah, let them eat, guys. You see? Yeah, let me take it to Stano so you can have some more. Guys, and I'm still eating my banana that we got from that tree there. Yeah. Guys, and for the first time I've seen how baby termites look like. They are white in color, and we have the big ones, and we have the whitish thing. That those are the eggs. Where are they? Okay, yeah, the white thing, they are here. Let me show you guys closely. Ah, okay, they're just this. Okay, you see the white thing that looks like rice, like this one here. You see that one there? Those are the eggs for the termites. And Stano is saying like he has to just try and peruse the place slowly, so he has to find the queen, because all these housings here means like there is definitely a queen here that's producing them, and these houses here are usually made for the queens by the other termites. Yeah, so he's still trying to find one, and it's not easy, guys. You see how it's a lot of hard work. Yeah. This is our neighbor's land, guys, you see? Yeah, let's see how everything goes. Hope you're gonna find the solution to this, guys, because we don't want to be doing zero work on our garden, trying so much to work hard to plant things, and then all of a sudden they are destroyed by termites. Yeah, they're still, see on the inside? Yeah, still trying to go deeper. Stano told us he already found it. Eh, hey, umechimba mbali. Kai. Imagine he started all the way there, coming all this place.
It's here.
Kai, this one is very big.
Where, so you think the small ones bring food?
Let us show them. Let me show them clearly using a... Guys, right now we are in class. The male is there, the small one.
So always the male must be there.
The male must be there, and that's the small one. And that's how it looks on the... Well, and this is the hide place. Guys, you can see house. And you have so many houses like there on the right. Yeah, like anytime you see such kind of things, you just know like the female, the queen is there. You see there are so many houses there, and this is the male. And umesema Stano, umesema these ones are the feeders.
Yeah,
as you can see, the male, the feeder. Ebu ivute tuone sai hakuna ingine ni hii tu. It has really taken him a lot of time, and that is the male. And this is the closer look of the female, guys. You see, that's how it looks from here. Where? Stano just ate that one, the male one, and this one.
Oh.
you want to eat that one? You just take it like that. He's already done with it.
Hey,
guys, I've never seen anyone eating that. Would you eat the queen of the termites, guys?
Okay, if it's eaten, it's eaten.
Yeah, if it's eaten. Yeah, and also my neighbor from my grandma's place, I have ever seen him eat that. So, yes, he does. Hey guys, it was not easy. You can see the whole spot that Stano has been digging. It's not an easy task, guys. We must respect people with their work, because if someone, but you see, he has really tried the best not to destroy this grass, so he's just going to return all the soil and then bring back the glasses, like just the way you'd close a page on a book. That's how well he tried to dig it. Guys, you know Stano also wants, you want to use also this other one? This is the one that you got at first. I don't know how. I was kicking too. Kai! Hey guys, that's very. You just swallow it once. And our chicken are really feasting on it. You see, guys, they are really enjoying. They just finished another batch that we poured on the back side of the house. And I think Stano is done now. He's going to go at my neighbor's place and see how everything goes. Yeah. The chicken are really having a lot of fun here, like a lot of food. And there's no way they're going to leave this place without finishing them. And Lynette is very determined. We are trying to find any spot that you're going to find anthills. But I think the two of them were really disturbing And
matumbe.
Eggs are here. This is my neighbor's place, guys, and you see he got one from that place there. Iko wapi queen yake?
Ndio.
Where is the queen? Oh, the queen. Oh, iko hapa. Oh, yeah. And that's the queen and the like lazima tu zikuwe mbili pamoja. The king and the queen. Okay, sawa sawa. I think this is a very big problem that you have to deal with. But at least we are slowly, so Stano is helping us solve the problem slowly by slowly. I'm really excited having this popo here. I tried to remember where this popo came from, guys. You can imagine we got this all the way from a place called Nakuru where we want to meet Joyce Helena. Joyce Helena, thank you so much. Your popo is ready and we are ready to enjoy and it looks so good. We have actually preserved the seed so we can have this breed as time goes by. Yes, it's very delicious, guys. You see there? Yes. Very delicious. Joyce Helena, thank you so much for the popo. Guys, right now when you try to look at any point around you, you will find that every place is green. And even the grass, the vegetation, the fence, the food, the trees, the bananas, everything, guys, they are green. And right now it's maybe close to 3 p.m. in the evening and you see like the clouds have already changed. Seems like the rain is going to come, but let's welcome it. Rain is a blessing and we thank God because we know how much it has saved us on our farm. So from this side, guys, I want to appreciate you guys for watching. Let me know what you think about the entire video. I love you guys so much from the bottom of my heart. Please subscribe if you haven't to Chalokush channel and also subscribe to Linet_KE. I love you guys so much. I tell you guys I love you. Bye bye. See you in the next video. Bye bye.